A lot of people have been hyping over an application called xTiles, and it's an experience that is similar to Notion in a way for you to daily plan, but has some hallmarks of other apps like Miro that allow you to build an experience that you want. Today, we're going to be reviewing xTiles to see whether it's right for you, and also addressing the concern of whether it's one of the best Notion replacements out there. Hello there, my name is Francesco and welcome to this channel. You can subscribe here, it'd be amazing, but you can also get our brand new newsletter about new tools. Every week I send you three new tools and you can find them linked below. Today's video is kindly sponsored by AkiFlow. You can explore them in the description below, but it's a powerful way for you to manage your tasks and calendar in one place. So, as I said, lots of hype about xTiles, and I'm going to start with the pricing. The pricing is fairly reasonable at around $5 for the premium or the personal premium pricing with other options as well. Now, I'll talk a little bit about that near the end in terms of how that correlates to the templates and things like that. But I first want to talk about what it exactly is. Well, xTiles is sort of a strange combination of a lot of different apps. What it wants you to do is help you to organize your day and your work through tiles. So very simply, you can drag things like tasks, notes, calendar, and even databases onto these tiles area and reshape them designed around what you want in different places. So similar to Notion in terms of a build your own workspace type experience, but with tabs for you to organize them in a much more structured fashion. So xTiles is a relatively new company. It's been growing quite rapidly and has been quite popular with the ADHD community as a good way to manage that aspect of their daily routine. And having that all in one place in a more structured sense is making it a lot more attractive to those on the market. So here we are with xTiles, and I want to show you around a few features and how it can be helpful to you. So here is a template that I've taken, which is a daily planner template. And you can start to see that initially what it looks like is sort of like Notion with a OneNote type feel. It's got that structure that we've seen in other productivity apps, but with that openness of being able to create what you want. Now you can see all of these things here can be moved around. They're tiles, so they'll essentially move around a little bit like tiles do. And you can make them smaller or bigger, and they sort of have an indication of the size of them on the left-hand sidebar. You can make them bigger if you do want to, which allows you to focus on them, but you can add a tile for whatever meets your needs. So you can add a note, you can add an image, you can add a task or a table. Now there's a few more options as well, but this is great for somebody who wants to make a to-do list or maybe make a mood board, all the way to making some sort of content calendar for their work that they're doing for work. And you can even take some of these templates, like this one has been created to be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So you can write your tasks in there and you can even interact with them. For example, give them dates and repeat them, which is a premium feature, but you get the idea. And any of those global tasks are brought in an area called tasks up here. Now, this is a nice feature because it means that it sort of separates it out in a little bit more detail. So if you're interested in exploring more note-taking apps, it's well worth checking out my free guide to note-taking apps. It'll help you pick the best one. And if you're watching this video and still umming and ahhing, this guide will help you and give you a few recommendations as well. So I'll find that linked below. So this, as you can see, is quite a nice way to manage your tasks. You can also do the same with an inbox, which you can use on iOS and Android to capture stuff, as well as Google Chrome. There's also a calendar, which is universal, which spans across not just your account or the template that you're in, but also your home area, which is a nice way to zoom out and see everything that's connected. If you have the premium, you can connect Google Calendar too. So the ideas are fairly simple, and there are tabs up here which allow you to organize stuff in a database fashion. Now, if you compare these databases to Notion, which I'll do a little bit later on, they're not as comparable, but they do the job. For example, you can move stuff around, you can create Kanban, you can add a table view. It's a few different options which give you a few different powers, which is good. So the free options are gallery, board, calendar, and table, but there are timeline and form which are available in premium, very much like we see in apps like Notion. This is a very easy way to structure your account, and you can have a few different tabs per area. Now, there are a few different templates you can use. You can even create a document, a page of a page group as well, which is helpful to bring tabs over here. And anything you want to create on each page can be pressed with a new. And if it's a database you're creating, it simply creates it in line. So I've seen many different examples of how people are using xTiles. And as you can see, a lot of people are going to use it for planning their day ahead. It gives you the structure that a lot of people struggle with Notion, as well as less know-how in how to set it up. There are a few differences when it comes to Notion, and that's the power of the databases and the customizability. It hasn't got as good of those than what Notion has. And also the templates are not as extensive. They do have a generous amount of free templates. However, the premium requires you to upgrade, which means giving you access to more templates. So it's sort of like there's a load of templates, but they're going to unlock when you're in premium, which is sort of a nice bonus if you're looking to save money, because some Notion templates can be expensive. So let's look at the pros and cons of xTiles. Maybe you're looking at it for your own note-taking slash planning experience. And I would say it's easy to use and it's quite playful. The application's fast and works well and allows you to just drag things in and move stuff about. It's sort of like a combination of Notion combined with Trello combined with Miro. A weird, strange baby that does make sense if you're looking for something more structured than Notion. It does, however, lack database abilities if you're coming across from Notion. The reason why I reference Notion quite a lot in this video is because so many people are considering this as the best alternative. Whereas if you put them like for like in terms of features and goals, then I think Notion wins, but xTiles does provide you with that structure and that light-hearted nature for planning ahead. The other thing as well is the premium does unlock a lot of the templates. So that is a little bit of a barrier to entry if you want to save a bit of time, but you do get unlimited blocks and pages as part of it. There are some limits on what actual pages are per account. And let me show you what. Per project, you can add up to 5 pages per project for the free account, which is a bit of a limitation, but then you get unlimited access if you upgrade. Now, the options are a little bit strange. There are some like New Year's bundles, which are priced at $59, but they actually give you access to 6 months of premium or plus, and then gives you a template. So it's strange. There are like template bundles on top of stuff, which can make things a little bit confusing. So it's well worth to look, see which one's suitable for you. So if you enjoyed this review, I'd really love to have you as a subscriber here. And if you want to check out more tools and resources, you know where to go. Toolfinder.co is the place to find tools and integrations for your work and life. So I look forward to helping you find those. And if you have any comments about xTiles, you can feel free to pop them below. It's an interesting option with a good potential and future. So hopefully that helps you pick whether it's right for you. Thank you so much for stopping by, and I will see you again in a future video. Cheerio.